G'day guys, just wanted to give you a very quick update on my German 250/9 little half track I'm doing. Pretty much all I've done in this video is I've put a Vallejo wash on it, and I've just started using graphite pencil just for some of the markings on the sides and the edges of the metal, just for some scratches. With these Vallejo washes, sometimes I find you can still add maybe another quarter of water to them when you drip them out into your tray or your little cup. I find that sometimes they still can be a little bit thick depending on how translucent you want the wash. So sometimes I add a little bit more water to these once I actually put them out in the paint tray. The reason why I've just done an overall wash in this colour is really just to dull down the white, and it also will be close to matching the mud colour that I'll probably end up putting on the half track as well. I'll just give you a quick turnaround. Hopefully if you've watched my last video you'll notice the difference in the white. I've pretty much got the same lighting in this video as I did in the last one. It's just got a very more faded effect to it, and obviously just the brown wash is just changing the tinting on the whole vehicle. As I've said before, this is just a test run on this vehicle for my Panzer 3, and I'm just trying out a couple of techniques. I'm going to try out some mud on it and some of the new Vallejo mud things. I think there's a Russian mud that I've got and a splash mud. I just want to try those out and see what they're like. But it's amazing that just this Vallejo wash, or any wash, can just change the colour of a tank so quickly, or the tinting of it very fast. Another thing I'd say about these Vallejo washes is, I went out to buy this to test it out, but don't be fooled, you can just get your normal Vallejo paint, and you can thin that down to a wash. So if you've got a Vallejo paint colour around this colour, in the normal paint, you don't really need to go out and buy this. You can thin down your paint and then just with water and just put a wash on it yourself, or any other paints. A long time before these were out, people were doing washes for many, many years. So don't be fooled. You don't need to go and buy these. You can use other paints and just thin them down. Obviously, this is a very quick and lazy way of doing it, just buying the paint. But if you've got a low budget for your modelling, don't go and buy a wash in this colour and a paint in this colour, because you're pretty much buying the same thing. But if you're happy to spend the money, this isn't too bad of a product straight out of the bottle. But as I've said before, I'm kind of adding water to it anyway, so I'm almost doing a wash again once I bring this out of the bottle. I'm adding water to it. So if you've got a small modelling budget, I'd say I wouldn't buy this. I'd buy a paint that you want in this colour and then thin it down, and then that way you'll have the paint to paint other things with, and you also have a wash as well when you need it. That's just my thoughts. Very simple to make a wash, just with water, with other paints or whatever the thinner is for the paint you're using, rather than going out and buying another whole bottle, which is, I'm not sure what this is worth. It might have been around $5 or $6, which is pretty much the same price as a standard Vallejo paint. So just be mindful of that if you've got a small budget. I'll do a little bit more detailing on this. Obviously, I've got to do the tracks and the wheels again, and obviously maybe some pin washers and just bringing out some of the panel lines a little bit more. And then I'll do another video. Okay, guys, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.